as far as what I think about Bob Lazar, yeah, when I wrote my second volume of UFOs in a National Security State years ago, I agonized over that. And all I tried to do, that was back in 2009 when I published that book, because I went into my research with Lazar, I was very much on the fence and I didn't know what I thought. And I assume everyone watching this knows Bob Lazar claimed to have seen flying saucers near Area 51 in a place he called S4 in Nevada in late 1988, early 1989, on I think a total of 6 occasions. He was interviewed by George Knapp in 1989 under a pseudonym originally, Dennis, I think, and then comes out as Bob Lazar by the, I think, in 1990. So, yes, I think I believe Lazar's story. No long. Eric Davis recently just said Lazar was full of it, and I was surprised because I know other people in that little world connected to Davis who I know that they believe Lazar's story. So I was a bit surprised when Davis said what he did, but yes, I think so. I don't know that everything Lazar said is true, but that doesn't mean that he's not being truthful. There's one theory that I find actually interesting that could square the circle. I mean, first of all, you got problems with Lazar's. Stanton Friedman talked about Lazar's educational issues. Like he said, he went to MIT. He never went to MIT. He said he went to Caltech. He never went to Caltech. Yeah, true. Two things I would say about that. One, look, I remember the 1980s. I lived through the 80s and the early 90s. And the fact was, back then, people lied about their credentials all the time. I mean, look, I don't defend the practice. I never did, but I knew a lot of people. I used to write professional resumes for job seekers, worked with thousands of people. And I knew, like, I can't do background checks on all these folks, but I knew they were not all truthful about their background. One woman finally, she was a very nice lady. She was the HR director somewhere. She said, yeah, I got fired because they found out that I didn't have this degree that I said I had. It's like, it was in the early 90s. Like, how many times did that happen? So did Lazar lie about his education? Yeah, probably. But actually, what I think he did is he may have audited a couple of courses at Caltech or MIT and for no credit. That's what it looks like to me, actually. So I'm like, look, am I going to throw his whole story out because he did that? That to me, that's just ridiculous. It's silly. There are people who would say, oh, well, he lied about that. I can't believe anything he says. Okay, fine. Fair enough. I'm not going to do that. So I want to look at the story. Can it be corroborated? Look, you talked to George Knapp, who interviewed Lazar. George has interviewed about 25 other people in addition to Lazar who have had stories very similar or that have corroborated various elements of what Bob Lazar has said. That doesn't prove Lazar is truthful, but there's a tremendous amount of corroboration. And keep in mind, Lazar was first to go public. He wasn't the first to talk to private researchers, but he was the first to go public. He's the reason we learned about Area 51, Lazar. He's the reason people knew where to go to look for the UFOs. He said they fly every Wednesday over in this location. They start going, like, how did he know that? He knew something. And they got arrested the second time they went out with John Lear and a couple of other people. And he got in trouble. And he lost his job and his clearance and whatever. But George, you know, did investigation of Lazar. He did find he worked at Los Alamos National Labs in 1982. He almost certainly did meet with Edward Teller, who probably got him the job at EG&G in 1988 to do what he did. Yes, I think so. So, and then you talk to people who knew Lazar before all of that. I have a friend named Ron Regier, who's a great guy. Ron knew Lazar back in the day. Back earlier, before 1989. And Ron, you know, what do you say? Ron's like, I'm telling you, man, Bob Lazar is 100%. So Lazar's got people who support him. And I listen to that. It doesn't mean that it informs my entire judgment, but I'm not going to blow off Ron Regier's assessment. I know and like and respect Ron.
If you enjoyed that clip, then the full podcast is out right now. You can click around here. Enjoy. Subscribe to Theories of Everything to get notified of upcoming podcasts as there are new full-length podcasts every week on the topics of mathematics, physics, consciousness, free will, and AI.